The Kingdom of Lesotho celebrating its independence from Britain. But 55 years on, this mountain kingdom of just over 2 million people is battling a myriad of challenges. Today, climate change tops the agenda. For this community, any kind of help to reclaim these wetlands will be highly appreciated, even from the Prime Minister himself.
What we have seen today is a continuation of a project that began in 2018. This is a future source of water and a future regulator of water. And to the extent that it regulates water flow, it also then stops the land degradation and degradation down.
The Prime Minister says while Lesotho has potential to feed itself, one out of three of Basotho are lingering in extreme poverty, mainly due to political instability that hinders national development by focusing on the wrong things.
From independence, first 5 years, and then political troubles begin in 1970, and they persist to 86. Army comes back in 86, we go to 93, a new government, a new democratic government comes in 93. But it's a government of people who were just the previous year refugees and had not been even living together, working in any format together. So they come and assemble in Maseru and they form a government. And immediately it becomes clear governing and governance is very challenging for them. So it's been a long struggle of focusing on the wrong things.
Dr. Majoro says he is worried with the recent spate of killings, which mostly seem to target the most vulnerable members of the society.
If you look at it carefully, it is violence against the weaker members of society by the stronger member of society. It is very difficult psychologically for me to understand why this violence is emerging in such a forceful manner. Apart from being a criminal matter, it is also a social and socio-economic issue of which we need to understand more deeply as government.
Lesotho is building up towards its bicentenary in the year 2024 since King Moshoeshoe first founded Basotho as a nation. Rabelang Khatebe, SABC News, Matsieng.